When Avatar hit the big screen in 2009, it was groundbreaking for a number of reasons. Sticking to theaters for a whopping 8 months, its groundbreaking visual effects and 3D imagery allowed for audiences to enter the new world of Pandora. Clearly, audiences love this world, as Avatar still stands as one of the highest grossing films of all time, with nearly $3 billion at the worldwide box office. However, James Cameron isn't the type of director to rush out a sequel just because the first was successful. Sure, he promised that there would be four more sequels, but he wasn't going to release said films until the technology was just right. Now the time has officially come, as after 14 years, fans and audiences alike can return to Pandora in Avatar: The Way of Water. Set sometime after the events of the first film, we find Jake Sully, once again played by Sam Worthington, and Neytiri, played once again by Zoe Saldana, raising a family of their own, but must continue their fight against the Sky People of Earth, who are still trying to conquer Pandora for its resources. Out on the hunt for Sully is General Quaritch, once again played by Stephen Lang, who is brought back in the body of a Na'vi and seeking revenge for his rather hilarious death in the previous film. Seeing Quaritch and his men will stop at nothing to capture them, Sully takes his family on the run and seeks refuge amongst the water tribes of Pandora. As the family hides out, they must learn the way of the people and adapt to their new aquatic surroundings. Right away, the thing everyone is wondering about is the visuals, and yeah, they're pretty amazing. Upon rewatching the original film a few days ago, I was surprised to find most of the effects and visuals still hold up surprisingly well, although they do have some cracks here and there. As much as we like to joke about James Cameron taking over a decade to release these films, it's clear that every moment was spent perfecting the visuals. While there's occasional CG effects that stick out, 99% of the visuals here are unbelievable, and I truly have no idea how they pulled off most of them. Once I adjusted to the 3D, there was no point when any of the visuals took me out of the film. I truly felt immersed in the world, and they were able to make the water in this film look absolutely breathtaking and awe-inspiring. Unfortunately, the visuals are the only thing really worth noting, because in all honesty, this new film did nothing for me. Keep in mind though that the original didn't really do anything for me either. Yeah, the world and visuals are really strong, but the story and characters and the message are simply too formulaic for me to care all that much. If you love the original or simply want to see cool imagery, then this film will satisfy you. As for me, I left this film feeling virtually nothing. For starters, this is literally just the first one repeated and set in the water this time. You might think I'm exaggerating, but that's not the case. It's just more of the first film. This means that a lot of the issues from that first film are present here as well. The message and themes are practically the same, with the same old story of destroying nature is bad. Just like the first, it doesn't bring anything new to the conversation and just wags its finger at the audience and tells you to feel bad for not respecting the environment. Which is an important message, don't get me wrong, but either provide a solution or a new perspective, or get off the soapbox. Speaking of new perspectives, we have a lot of new characters on top of the returning ones. In fact, another major issue is there's way too many characters to keep track of. You have Sully and Neytiri, now sidelined to be disappointed parents, in particular Neytiri, who is given nothing to do until about the final 20 minutes of the movie. Then you have the returning Quaritch, who isn't as generically evil as he was in the first film, but he and the other antagonists go missing for large chunks of the movie, so by the time he comes around in the final act, you almost kind of forget he was there. Plus, the human villains are somehow even more cartoonish than they were in the first one. The real main characters of the film are Sully's children, who are so interchangeable that I struggle to even remember their names at this point. The only one who has anything remotely interesting to do is Kiri, and yes, I did have to Google that name to make sure I was thinking of the right one. She's played by Sigourney Weaver, but they leave much of her story ambiguous, so I assume they can explore it in later sequels. Although with Kiri, I think the thing I was focusing on the most is how weird it was to hear Weaver's voice coming out of this clearly teenage body. I want to emphasize that the cast isn't bad here. The new cast is clearly trying, and the returning cast are still giving strong performances. In cases like Worthington, I think he actually got better from the first film. It's just the fact that the visuals were the clear focus here and little was put on writing them to be interesting or engaging. I mean, for God's sakes, you have Kate Winslet, one of the greatest living actresses of our time, and she's barely in the movie. I practically didn't even recognize her half the time.
Is our fortress.
Look, Avatar The Way of Water clearly has a lot of passion behind it, and when the film focuses on the visuals, and only the visuals, it's a good time. It truly is breathtaking. Unfortunately, when it focuses on literally anything else, it's just kind of bland. The story is one you've seen before, these characters are ones you've seen before, and even though the film is essentially a repeat of the first one, it's somehow longer as well. There's maybe enough material here for 2.5 hours at most, but this film is somehow sitting at a whopping 3 hours and 12 minutes. I do think people should see the film, in particular on the biggest screen possible and in 3D, so you truly feel immersed in the world, but if you don't care for this world like I do all that much, then you'll only get the bare minimum of entertainment from this new installment. I really hope that James Cameron tries to switch things up a bit for the next 3 movies, because I don't think I can go see the same movie again for either a 3rd, 4th, or a 5th time.